there's something that not exactly easy to find on the Volvo S60 2001-09 with the automatic transmission AC in 5 speeds is the dipstick. Especially on turbo models, this is the turbo one, they have extra hoses here. There goes your dipstick, it's right there. So behind is just underneath this hose, underneath this radiator hose. This is where the dipstick sits. It's right there. You notice this wire loom goes downwards and goes right near the dipstick. Yet another view for the steep dipstick from this other car. Again, this is the radiator hose. The dipstick is really under it. And you have this wire loom which may be very close to the dipstick itself. And you notice the clamp that you need to keep the press, and with the other finger pull the dipstick from there. Then you need to get your hand in front of the this big hose under the radiator hose, under this hose from one side, and on top of the wire loom, the big one, just with your thumb nail depress that clamp, with the index pull the dipstick from there, just like that. And there comes the dipstick. I can just pull it from left side of the radiator hose. Just like that. This is a early 2001-02 non-turbo engine. The non-turbo have this hose. Early one had the Maranelli throttle body, which takes a little bit more space. On 2003 and up, the space here is reduced and access is better, but still the dipstick is right there, you can see it. So bury your hand on the left of the radiator hose and you can reach. You notice where my hand is, right under the hose. Again, pull that metal tab with one finger and the dipstick with another finger. So just a small move like this, toss the dipstick on the side like this, comes on the left of that hose, and it's the same measurement as on the turbo engines. You need a butter knife, slide the butter knife in there, twist it a little bit and toss this guy away. Don't pull without the butter knife, you are going to break it. Check the fluid with a fully hot engine, really full. In winter time, I don't think you want to reach that temperature. You need to have 80 degrees Celsius, the fluid inside the transmission, not the engine. So that takes at least 30 minutes in hot summer weather. City driving, you need to have the car parked on level, engine running, idle in park. So you notice there's the hot mark and the cold mark. Usually this one you should never use it. I think it's just for the garages when they refill the new transmission and the engine is still cold, but it's not the measurement here. So you have to have the fluid at this mark here. Look for something like a thicker fluid, not just smear. When you pull it from the dipstick, it may have smear all over the place. So look for the thicker area with fluid, and it should be right there on top of it. Use 3309 fluids, either mobile 3309. Careful, is not the same as mobile ATF regular. Toyota Type 4 from your Toyota dealer, 3309. Manual in Europe also has 3309. I did not have that good experience with the Valvoline Max Life, which is also 3309, was expanding too much in summer and shrinking too much in winter. Again, it's very important, car level and transmission fully warmed up. If your transmission is not fully warmed up, this level varies a lot. If your transmission maybe is a 60 degrees Celsius, it will stay here. At 80, it will stay here. So that's not a good measurement. You need to really warm it up to 80 degrees Celsius. If you have VIDA, you can check it in VIDA when you reach the temperature. And then I think the difference on a hot engine between this mark and this mark is 20 millimeters, so it's not a lot. We always refill only by the dipstick. Do not remove any bolt on top of the transmission, you are going to lose gears. Only remove refill on the dipstick. We like to use a big funnel. You find one in dollar store. that has a thin end, and maybe just warm up the bottles with transmission so it flows easier. Transmission should be fluid, should be replaced every, I would say, not more than 50,000 miles. Either drain it, or either refill it with the Gibson method. Undo this clip. Just check forums online. So toss that guy away, and then toss this bracket a little bit like this. Slide the hose from the bracket itself. And so this is how it looks. You just open a little bit that clamp bracket and just toss the hose, and the hose may even stay there if you keep this clamp a little bit close, and just sit it like this with the on cold engine, and then you can really reach for the dipstick very easily.